watching Blue Blood Sports TV.
Shout out to Blue Blood Sports TV.
You're watching Blue Blood Sports TV.
Shout out to Blue Blood Sports TV.
You're watching Blue Blood Sports TV.
Hola, habla Cindy. Está viendo Deportes TV.
What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, Blue Blood Sports TV, back at y'all with another one. So, newly crowned, unified Mexican heavyweight champion Andy Ruiz Jr. clowns former unified British heavyweight champion Anthony Joshua, his foe, ahead of their rematch, should be taking place November 16th, 2019, Madison Square Garden, New York, New York. So with that said, Andy Ruiz Jr. clowns Anthony Joshua. I did a video about Anthony Joshua consistently posting and updating his current training regimens and the things that he's doing. Andy Ruiz also noticed this, took notice to it. He put up the same type of training method, doing the X ropes, bobbing underneath, and jabbing underneath the ropes. Right, and the X drill in the ring, and he put up the same video of him doing the same thing in training, and he says, you know, fluidity, right? He also went to Anthony Joshua's, reposted Anthony Joshua's, as you can see, and stated and put the robot emoji, saying stiff, wow, saying that he's a big stiff, saying he's a big robot. This has been ongoing. You know, everybody says Anthony Joshua lacks head movement. He lacks fluidity. He lacks mobility. You know, he looks very robotic. He looks very textbook. You know, it's like there's a book in front of him and he's trying to follow the guidelines in the book, right? And so this is nothing new. You know, everybody has been saying this about Anthony Joshua, and Andy Ruiz continues to highlight it. He's very, very confident ahead of the rematch. Andy Ruiz believes his skill set, his IQ, and what he does in the ring will trump what Anthony Joshua does in the ring in the rematch, as it did in the first fight. Andy Ruiz is citing that in the first fight, only had a five-week camp. Going into the second fight, I'm going to have a full training camp. So imagine what's going to happen in the second fight when I have full time to prepare for him, and I already know what he brings to the table. I already know what his punching power feels like. I already know what little flaws, what little hints that he give away. You know, I already understand. I already soaked it in. I already processed the data of Anthony Joshua. And still, in the first fight, I dropped him four times and I stopped him. You know, and I had a short training camp. I didn't have a long time to prepare for him. This time, I'm gonna have even more time to prepare for him. I'm gonna be in more shape, I'm gonna be even more focused, and I'm gonna be even more understanding to what he brings in the ring, and I'm gonna defeat him once again. You know, he's very robotic, he's very stiff, and my style is all wrong for him. I have to agree with Andy Ruiz Jr. I think that Anthony Joshua is definitely lacks head movement, he lacks stamina, and he's very stiff and robotic. With that said, this makes this fight even more interesting because I can't wait to see what wrongs Anthony Joshua corrects in the rematch, if any at all. I can't wait to see if Andy Ruiz's style is all wrong for Anthony Joshua, as so many people so put it. As I saw in the ring, I think that styles make fights, and I think that Andy Ruiz Jr.'s style is all wrong for Anthony Joshua, personally myself. I think his counterpunching ability, his quick hands, his quick feet is the kryptonite to Anthony Joshua, because Anthony Joshua has slow feet, he's very stiff, he has slow hands, you know, compared to the people that he's fought, you know, he has fast hands. But when you put him in there with elite fighters with fast hands, you see what fast hands look like. You understand? There's a lot of fighters that have fast hands, and then you put them in the ring with a Gary Russell, a Floyd Mayweather, a Sugar Ray Leonard, a Zab Judah, you know, fighters of that caliber, and then they suddenly don't look so fast. You understand what I'm saying? So, you know, Andy Ruiz Jr. looked like the much faster guy. He was beating Anthony Joshua to the punch. Every time Anthony Joshua threw a jab or a power punch, Andy Ruiz was willing to counter. Andy Ruiz is willing to go through fire to defeat Anthony Joshua. Let's see if he still has that hunger going into the rematch. But this is just making this fight even more exciting. It's adding more fuel to the fight. The storyline is getting bigger and bigger by the minute. Anthony Joshua say he want to go back to the scene of crime where it all took place and right his wrongs, back at Madison Square Garden, back in New York, you know, in the Mecca, to right his wrongs in the rematch. So let's see how this all plays out. I can't wait. But that's all I got for y'all, man. Drop a comment in the comment section. Let me know what y'all think. Y'all already know what it is. It's your boy, Blue Blood Sports TV. Hate, like, comment, and subscribe. If you haven't subscribed, hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, hit the bell icon to get all the new notifications. Follow me on Instagram at Blue Blood Sports TV, all one word. Y'all already know what it is. Shout out to the entire LDBC. Shout out to New Media. Shout out to Black Media Row. Make sure you like and share these videos. That's all I got for y'all. Andy Ruiz Jr. makes fun of Anthony Joshua and clowns him, puts up a robot emoji with Anthony Joshua sparring, and also puts up a duplicate of him doing the same type of routine, the same regiment, and saying that fluidity. Wow. I can't wait for this fight to take place, man. That's all I got for y'all, man. Peace. It's your boy, Blue.